This is my 8th day update. I've done really well this week. The day that I got home, I had a lot of gas in my chest, and that's pretty much gone now. I've been on a liquid diet. I was on the first 2 days I was on broth and water and Jell-O, apple juice. The third day I moved up to yogurt and cream soup, and man, I'm telling you, that was like second status, because I hadn't ate since about 1 o'clock Saturday afternoon. So that yogurt was like second status, honey, I tell you. But then my next step was, I don't remember, but I can now eat peanut butter, cooked vegetables as of yesterday, baby food. That was my next step, was baby food between us. And my next step to move up won't be until day 14. But I'm doing really good. I feel good. I feel awesome. I got out of the house Saturday. And, no, I got out of the house Friday and went and paid bills. I was still kind of sore. Saturday, I got out, went shopping, got my hair done. I got my hair cut. Oh, my hair is cut to, like, right here. It's about this long. But, it looked cute. And then yesterday, I have really fine hair, really. Like curly hair, and I was getting ready for church, and I had my hair, my real hair out, and then I just couldn't do it, so, you know, you see the result now. But anyway, I'm doing extremely well. I think the pain that I'm having now isn't from the lap band itself. As I told you all, they found a hiatal hernia, and they repaired that, and that's kind of sore. But the bulk of my pain has been, you know, when I sleep, I couldn't sleep the first few nights. It's just been maybe 3 or 4 nights that I've really got a good night's sleep, because the gas, man, the gas that they use, it gets in your chest, and it's all up in your shoulder, and it's so hard to get rid of. And I know this is nasty, but I couldn't even, you know, pass gas until Wednesday? Until Wednesday. And then, I mean, it gave me so much relief just to do that. And then, because I was scared, I was thinking that the bottom part of my digestive system was not working whatsoever. But and then Thursday, I finally had a little bit of a bowel movement. I know that's gross, but that's important to know for people who, you know, may be going through the same process and think something's wrong. It'll eventually come. So I feel terrific. I'm going to get up and put on some clothes and go see my students today. I'm out until December 8th. But, which is 3 weeks. But, you know, I really miss my students, and it's before Thanksgiving, and tomorrow's their last day. So I want to go up and see them, surprise them. Do y'all want to see my students? I don't know if I want to expose them. But, okay. I think I told you guys I should have had 5 incisions, but I had 6. But yesterday when I was taking a shower, I actually had 7. There's a very tiny little incision beside my port, where they put my port in. So there's 2 there. I couldn't see it because they still have that tape on there, and I couldn't see it. But it's very hard for me to wear a bra. It's very hard for me to wear pants, because all but 2 of my incisions are around my waistline. And the 2 that are not are up right, I'll show you, right by my breastbone. So it's hard for me to wear a bra. So I've been wearing this little tank top before I take my shirt off. This little tank top, and it kind of has a bra made into it. So, That's what I've been. And I can't even wear that for long because it's not too comfortable. Now, anyway, these are my incisions. I have seven. I don't know if you can see this. Okay. Now, this is my left side. I still have tape on that, on this one. On this one because they told me it'll fall off on its own. But I believe that's where my hernia, that was my hernia. That's my left side. And I have another incision beside that. Here. And they derma bonded these together. So I'm just going to slowly go around my stomach. That's the one I had just showed you where I think they did the hernia. And then I have another one right beside that. Derma bonded together. And then another one there. And my last one at the bottom is now. I'm gonna try to do this without exposing my breast, but this is where my port is. They were going to put. Okay, anyway, my computer was messing up, but here is where my port is. It's not on the left side. They didn't put it there because of some type of tissue. Two there. I'm not sure what the point was for that, but anyway, I feel great. I'm sure I've lost some weight. I'm not going to get on the scale until I go for my first fill on December the 15th. A follow-up appointment. I don't know if they'll do a fill the first follow-up appointment. I'm doing great, guys. Oh, some things that they told me would happen, and I was like, whatever. My sense of smell, oh, everything stinks. I get out the car and I'm like, what is that smell? I smell everything. And my sense of taste, those Special K protein waters that I told you guys were so good, taste like Kool-Aid. Oh my gosh. They are the most disgusting some things I've ever put in my mouth. Yesterday I was able to move up to vegetables and potatoes and oatmeal. So I had oatmeal for breakfast. I had some mashed potatoes for lunch, and for dinner, I ordered my kids spaghetti from this Italian restaurant, and I got me a portobello sandwich with no bread. So I had, it was basically a huge portobello mushroom top with cheese and tomatoes on it. And I'm telling you, that was from Dilly Umptious. yeah, I can have cheese now too, though. Something else that was added. But I'm excited, guys. This, having the surgery is not only just having the surgery. Before I had the surgery, like Saturday and Sunday, I was kind of, thinking about things in my life, things that I need to change, things that, people that should be in my life that isn't, people I should have kept around, people that are in my life that shouldn't be. So, when you are faced with the possibility of dying, anytime you go under, there's a possibility of dying. And them messing with my liver scared me to death. But, it didn't scare me to death. But I just think I thought about some things, made myself right with God. I'm a Christian. I go to church. I pray. I teach my kids to pray. I read the Bible. But there are some things that I saw in my life that need some improvement, and that's what I'm gonna work on. That's what I'm working on. So, I'm ready to be a new woman.